In this video, I want to share my thoughts on the book, The Political Mind, Why You Can't Understand 21st Century with an 18th Century Brain, by George Lakoff, or Lakoff? George Lakoff, L-A-K-O-F-F. Don't really know how to pronounce that, but that's the book. It's really a book intended for, I guess, like, liberals who want to win the political battle against conservatives. He refers to liberals as progressives, and conservative as he really uses conservative, the word conservative, with a negative connotation. So you can kind of imagine that, you know, you can already see that this book starts out with a really, really biased tone. I really wonder what a conservative might think when reading this book, because it just paints them as this evil, totalitarian, controlling kind of people. But the main, the good parts of the book that I really took a lot of, because he's a neuroscientist, and his specialty, I guess, is with neuroscience and linguistics. So he sees the effect of language on the human brain. And one thing that he says in the book, which is, I guess, scientific fact, kind of, I'm not really sure how true it is, but I guess the fact that, or the belief of the fact that 90% of human actions is unconscious, or subconscious. Really, everything that we do happens without our awareness of it. For example, a good example is that I'm blinking, but I'm not controlling my blinking. I'm breathing, but I'm not really controlling my breathing. And the thought and the words that come out right now as I speak are, in a way, is happening kind of automatically. I'm not thinking of individual words to pick out. It's just kind of happening because I've done it so much before. Once I learned speaking, and I kept speaking and speaking, this art of conversation, picking out which words to choose, picking out how to make that sentence work in speech, it happens kind of automatically. It kind of happens subconsciously. And so he really emphasizes this point and how this plays into politics and with the brain, and how politics affects our brain, and how our brain affects the politics and stuff like that. And I guess he's saying that this is his question with the book, I think. The question is, why are conservatives so successful politically, even though what they propose are totally, well, this is his point of view. I don't really agree that conservatives are like this, but he's saying, how can they be so successful when they're so against the Constitution, when they're so against human rights, when they're so against, you know, like, liberty, freedom, and all that kind of stuff? How can they be successful when they're so bad, is pretty much his question, which is why I think conservatives will get a kick out of this book, and maybe they'll get super angry when they read it, or maybe they'll just be like, this guy's nuts, and laugh at it. But his bias view aside, the point he makes is that conservatives are really, really good with their presentation because of how they phrase things and how they use the words, you know, the words that we subconsciously begin to connotate ourselves, and gradually adding their kind of connotation to it, such as the word socialism. You know, when we hear that word in public debate today, that word in American politics has nothing but negative connotations. You know, we say, this law is socialist, and automatically that means not necessarily that it's socialist, but that it's horrible, that it's going to destroy the American public. Which is what, of course, exactly what conservatives tried to do with the healthcare bill. And partly they succeeded. And so he really emphasizes the power of language in political discourse. So he even goes away, so he's saying liberals should probably do the same thing. Try to use language in a way that manipulates their political agenda, instead of trying to, the reason he says why, and the subtitle of the book, Why You Can't Understand 21st Century with an 18th Century Brain, is because he's arguing that the 18th century brain, the brain of the Enlightenment, is the one that thinks humans think rationally, that reason is the ultimate goal of human beings. But he's saying that with the development in neuroscience in 21st century, people don't always think rationally. And in fact, rationality has a lot of emotions behind it. And therefore, if you want to make politics work, if you want to sell your political agenda, then you gotta manipulate emotions. And he's saying this is what Republicans and conservatives do really well. And he's also saying that there is no center line between two politics. Either one person is conservative about this issue or liberal about this issue. There is no moderation with certain issues, which I kind of disagree, but in a lot of ways it makes a lot of sense. If you're, you know, there is kind of, if you're decided on something, you're decided on something. There is no kind of moderate view. The only reason it's moderate is because on these issues you're conservative, on these issues you're liberal. So when you kind of combine them together, it doesn't really seem like, if you have a lot of this, if you have a lot of number of issues that you're conservative about, I mean, if you have a lot of number of issues that are liberal about, you know, it's kind of a tie. You know, you're, I don't know, for example, maybe you're you're pro-life, but you're anti-Iraq war. You know, so those two things, two completely different issues, one you're completely conservative about, one you're completely liberal about, but maybe you align yourself, you consider yourself to be Republican or Democrat because you're against war in Iraq. And it's just kind of saying that, you know, it's not about the issues, but it's really about how you spin things. So, in a way, this book is kind of like a propaganda book. How do you propagandize? Using manipulating the human brain. It all sounds really bad, but I guess in the world of politics, this is what is done. And he's saying that the Democrats, which he's strongly in favor of, apparently, because, you know, you could notice in his biased tone, and I'm not going to go into his politics, because I'm actually independent. I'm neither. Or I'm actually super liberal, and I think Democrats are not liberal enough. But that's me. Where was I? But thing is, the manipulation of politics, it just sounds bad, but that's his point, you know, that politics, that's how it should play. It's just that every day, we get loaded words thrown at us. And if those loaded words get, it's how we kind of view those loaded words that the political sides win. For example, the word socialism, conservative has totally owned that word. You know, now they own that word. You know, if you're trying to fight a battle against that concept, against that word, he's saying you don't use the opposition's terms, don't use the opposition's rules. For example, one of the examples he gave was, of course, the Iraq war, and the war against terror. He's saying that by the conservative framing as a war against terror, and so the talk show hosts like to ask, you know, are you saying that we're losing the war against terror? Well, he's saying the war against terror is a subconscious effort on their part to kind of manipulate that term into thinking that this is a war. And when in fact, we should actually call it not a war at all. And we should just, the liberals should. Not be in that war frame of mind, which makes them lose this course. And so it's this kind of book that it is, which I think is really interesting. I think my favorite chapter was on Anna Nicole Smith and how her life is actually the best example of how American politics plays, which makes a lot of sense in a way. And, you know, that's pretty much the book, you know, manipulation of the human language in order to make your political agenda work. Of course, he's on the side of the liberals and the Democrats, so all his book is pretty much advice on how Democrats can win against Republicans manipulating language. So I would really be interested in how a conservative might think about this book, just because of how biased it is. It's ridiculously biased. But yeah, so those are my thoughts.